Hey guys, what's up? So my latest poll on what to teach next, the Captain America shield won 62% of your votes. So in this intro, I wanted to dress for the occasion. So I ordered a Captain America's costume online, but it's not gonna come for another week. So I was like, what am I gonna do? Avengers, assemble. This is going to work, because I don't know what I'm going to do if it doesn't. Fold we will, whatever it takes. Here goes. Alright, so for this Captain America shield, I used a rectangle of Wyndstone marble. That's two normal sized sheets of Wyndstone marble taped together by the long edge. Instead of cutting off the extra rectangle, I just folded it behind. And that gave me this pocket to hold the shield. So if you're using A4 paper or printer paper, after you fold the short edge onto the long edge and fold the extra behind, then you unfold here and fold this behind, and then fold this up like this, and here we have the intersection point, so fold this down to here, then fold this to here, and so on, like that, and fold this behind, and there you have your pentagon, and you'll end up with a shield that you can stick your hand in. But don't worry if you didn't catch that, because I'm now going to really teach the pure origami Captain America shield from a square sheet of kami, and it flies. Here goes. All right, so for a white star on a blue shield, let's begin blue side up, or colored side up, and fold in half. Try to make really precise folds and crease sharply, and rotate. And now fold this flap up to this edge, but don't fold the whole thing, just align perfectly and make a fold right in the middle of the blue square and unfold. And now fold this edge to the top. But again, don't make the whole fold. Align perfectly and just fold right on the existing crease there and unfold. And now rotate and fold this corner, not the open side, but this corner to the intersection of the creases like that. And make the fold and rotate. And fold this flap up so that this edge aligns with this edge. And fold this flap up to this edge. And turn over and fold this edge to this edge. Now holding the layers together, fold the top behind on this edge and crease it nice and sharply and now completely unfold. And here we have a pentagon of creases. Let's fold along that pentagon of creases. Make sure that you're on the pentagon of creases. And now fold this flap up so that this corner lands on this crease. And we want this edge to land on this point where this crease touches that edge. So it's like that. And rotate. And now fold this corner up so that the corner lands on the crease and this edge touches this point. So it's like that. And now fold this corner up. And just make sure that these two points are equal, like that. And fold this corner up. And one last corner. And just try to make it be a perfect star. Now unfold here, partially unfold here. And refold here and just continue that fold like that and flatten so that way it's rotationally symmetric. Now turn over and fold in half, but not exactly in half. We want to fold on the middle point, but we want this crease to land on the middle crease behind it. So when that lines up, don't fold sharply here, just fold like that and now fold these three corners over the edge. One, two, and three. Don't worry about folding them sharply yet. And now turn over and fold these two corners over. And now unfold, and now remake those five folds sharply. Okay, so like this, it'll fly, maybe not so well, but if you like it like this, then you're done. But if you want it to fly really well, then this is what you do. Unfold these flaps and pick the lightest one, the one with the fewest layers, and open here and open here and stick your hand inside. Now pinch on this existing crease and this one and this one. So it's like this. Now pinch here and pinch these two edges together and pinch these two edges together. Now, if you want the shield to spin clockwise, then you're going to lift up the right flap and we're going to stick it inside there. If you want it to spin counterclockwise, then lift up the left flap. I want to flick it like a flicker so it spins counterclockwise. So I'm going to lift up the left flap and now fold it inside so it's like this, and then close it up and flatten it so it's like that. And now do the same thing on the remaining 4 points. And I'm gonna fast forward this part. Hopefully you'll be able to do it even though the layers are thicker. And now pinch it nice and sharply. Make sure that the corners are still landing on the creases so that the five-pointed star looks nice. If you need to, then adjust the folds. Okay, so if you like it like this, then you're done. We have a decagon. But to make it fly even better, let's turn over and fold all 10 points in. So instead of a decagon, we're going to have an icosagon, which is a 20-sided polygon. And I'm gonna fast forward this part too. And go around making those nice and sharp. And we are ready to fly it. Let's see how it flies.
Some people cut tape and glue, but not us. Not us.